Welcome back to Mayhem and Family Fun. Today I'm going to read another story since I was supposed to read day four today. It's about the tale of two bad mice. So there are the mice. Once upon a time, there's a very beautiful doll's house. It was a red brick with white windows and had very real musical curtains in the front door and a chimney. So there, the chimney. It belonged to two dolls called Lucien and Jane. At least it belonged to Lucien, but she never ordered meals. Jane was the cook, but she never did any cooking because the dinner had been bought ready and made in a box for shavings. So there is the doll. There were two red lobsters and a ham, a fish, and pudding. There were some pears and oranges, They would not come off the plates because they were extremely beautiful. So they're like fake foods. There's their food. One morning, Lucien and Jane had got out for a drive in the doll's pergola. But there was no one in the nursery, and it was very quiet. Presently, there was a little scuffling, scratching noise in the corner near the fireplace, where there was a hole under the skirting board. Tom Thumb put his head out for a moment, and then popped it in again. Tom Thumb was a mouse. So there are the mouse. I'm guessing they're bad mice. They never know. A minute afterwards, Huna and Mooka put it. His wife put her head out, too. And then when they saw there was no one in the nursery, she rented off the royal cloth under the coal board. Coal box. So there is the wife and the husband looking out the window. The doll's house stood at the other side of the fireplace. Tom Thumb and Hooka Mooka were cautiously across the hearth rug. They pushed the front door. It wasn't fast. So there are cheeky little mice going into the doll's house. Tom Thumb and Mooka went upstairs and peeped into the dining room. Then they squeaked with joy. Such a lovely dinner was laid upon the table. There were tin spoons and bed knives and forks and two doll chairs. So confident. So where are the two blind mice? I said two blind mice. They're not blind. They can see. Tom Thumb set to work at once to carve the ham. It was a beautiful, shiny, yellow streaked with red. The knife crumbled up and hurt him. He put his finger in his mouth. It's not boiled enough. It is hard. You have a try, Hoopa and Mooka. So where... Then there is him trying to cut the ham, but it won't go much. Huna Mooka stood up in her chair and chopped up the ham with another lead leg. It's hard as the hand of the cheesemongers, said Huna Mooka. There's the mice trying to cut up the ham, but it's too big. It's too hard. The ham broke off the plate with a jerk and rolled on the table. Let it alone, said Tom Thumb. Give me another fish, Huna Mooka. So there, as you can see, the ham fell off the table and rolled on the table. Huna Mooka tried every tin spoon in turn. The fish was glued to the dish, and Tom Thumb lost his temper. He put the ham in the middle of the floor and hit it with the tongs and with the shovel bang, and smash, smash. The ham flew onto the pieces, all into pieces. The shiny paint, it was made of nothing but plaster. So look. Down there, see all those yellow, white stuff? That was the break of the plate and the meat. But there was no end of the rage and discipline with Tom Thumb and Hannah Makata. They broke up the pudding, the lobsters, and the pears and the oranges. As the fish would not come off the plate, they put it into the red hot crinkly paper and fryer in the kitchen. They wouldn't burn either. Everything's faking at the old house. Well, there they are trying to dump it in the fire, but it would not break. Tom Thumb went up to look in the kitchen chimney and looked out the top. There was no suit. So up there, that black thing, that's a bug on the dock. While Tom Thumb was up the chimney, Hannah Makata had another disappointment. She found some teeny canisters above the dresser labeled rice, coffee, cider. But when she turned them upside down, there was nothing inside except red and blue beans. See, look. Whoops. There. The thing she's dumping is beets. There's nothing good in this house. Maybe. Then those mice set up to work to do all the mischief they could, especially Tom Thumb. He took Jane's clothes out of the chest of the drawers in her bedroom and threw them out the top of the floor window. But Hannah Makata had a federal mind. After pulling half the feathers out of Lucy's bolster, she remembered that herself. That she was once in a feather bed. So there she is, inside of the bed, and Tom Thumb throwing stuff out the window. Pretty usual for a mischief rat. Tom Thumb insisted she carry the bolster upstairs, downstairs, and across the hub. It was difficult to squeeze the bolster into the mouse hole. She managed it somehow. So there they are, taking that bolster into their hole. Trying to get her in the hole. Then Hannah Carter went back and fetched the chair and a bookcase. A birdcage and several small odds and ends. The bookcase and the birdcage refused to go into the mouse hole. So they're too big. So there. They're trying to fit in the hole, but it won't fit. Hannah Makata left them behind the cold box and went to fetch the cradle. Why the cradle? That's for babies. It's a cradle. Hannah Makata were just returning with another chair. When suddenly there's a noise of talking outside upon landing. The mice rushed back to the hole and the dolls came into the nursery. Oh no, they're coming. They came home. Look, here they are scrambling, and in the back are the dolls. They saw them. This is the last of two more pages. What a sight met the eyes of Lumen and Jane and Lumen. Lumen sat up the stove and started, and Jane leant across the kitchen dresser and smiled, but neither of them made any remark. So there were the dolls, not talking. The bookcase and the birdcage were rescued from under the coal box, but Hannah Makata has got the cradle and some of Lucent's clothes. What? They had a baby! They have a baby! They have a baby! See that thing she's holding? That's another rat. Oh, what romantic couple. She also had some useful pots and pans and several other things. Those are useful. There's her with her pots and pans. The little girl that the doll's house belonged to said, I will get a doll dressed like a policeman. So there's a policeman telling her, probably telling him not to go back in the dollhouse. Hey, don't go back in the dollhouse, you stupid rat. I mean, he's not stupid, they're kind of cute. And then that's the end. Let me say, whoops. Oh, I skipped a page, that's why. But the nurse said, I'll set a mouse trap. So that is the story of the two bad mice, but they were not. They were not so very, very naughty, after all, because Tom Thumb paid for everything he broke. So there are his children, didn't have anything to do with them. He found a crooked sixpence under the hearth rug and upon the Christmas Eve, and he had And she moves it, stuffing in one of the stockings of Lucy and Jane. So there, they console things. In a very early morning, before anybody is awake, Luna Makata comes with her dustpan and broom to sweep the dolly's house. What a nice little rat. The end. Now that's finally the end. The Tale of Miss Piggy Wiggle, which will be tomorrow, day 5. So that was the tale of the two bad mice. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll try not to forget tomorrow, and it'll be all mixed up. So bye!